to everybody. We know we were doing those episodes, and we're done with those episodes. But also, we wanted to hop back on here because we just did our engagement photo shoot, which was such an awesome experience. It was at the Grant Park in Chicago, downtown Chicago, the Formal Gardens, and it was awesome. And for those of you who supported us and voted for us for that one contest that we came in second place, you guys were so gracious to vote for us. We didn't win that one, but we did win this one. So this contest was you had to share your love story with a photographer, and you had to submit pictures of yourself. And that's exactly what I did. And we were one of the winners. So it was really awesome. She is amazing, an amazing photographer. You could check her out. Her name is Marie. And on here, she is Nicole Marie Photography. And we'll tag her in the video when we're done. But it's Nicole Marie Photography. And she was so awesome. First of all, we like to work with people that we like. And her personality was amazing. We both are energetic. We're fun. We like to have fun. And we just really vibed with her. She was a sweetheart. She was energetic. She was fun. She was awesome, professional, knew what she was doing. And it was just really amazing to work with her. You could check her out. Again, we'll share all of her information when we're done with this video. Her website's amazing. She has a lot of great information on there as well, if you're into photography as well, for anyone who wants to learn more about that. But her Instagram is nice as well. So, again, we'll add all of that. But she's also blogger, and she did a sweet vlog on us. It was so sweet. We wanted to kind of share it with you guys. Is there a lot of feedback, or can you guys hear me?
You're fine.
Okay, so I'm just gonna quickly read it. It's not really long what she wrote, and it was entitled Elegant Grant Park Formal Gardens Engagement Session. We met in the soft light of the morning for this elegant Grant Park Formal Gardens engagement sessions. With the sun tucked away behind the clouds, I snapped photos of each embrace and smile throughout the gardens. It was a magical morning. Charbria and Louis glowed in their gorgeous outfits. From her soft pink flowy dress to his stunning light pink velvet jacket, they looked absolutely fabulous. The elegance of their outfits looked perfect in the lush greens of Grant Park. It was a true pleasure getting to photograph them. Their love story starts like something out of a movie. He saw her in a picture. Maybe it was the vibrancy of her beautiful smile or the beauty she exudes. And, like any good man, he was smitten. They were destined to meet and fall in love. It just took a little time, meaningful conversations, and a bit of travel. After hours on the phone, Louis made the first long drive so they could meet in person. With many miles between them, they began to break all the odds with a romance that spanned across states. While long-distance love is hard, yes, it is, y'all, in love, falling in love can be pure magic. With love in their hearts, they maintained a long-distance relationship, and as the story goes, when you know, you know. When Louis surprised Charbria with a proposal on one of their visits, she said yes. I said yes, y'all. Now they get to plan their beautiful summer wedding and finally be together always. Just by looking at them together, it's obvious their love is real and vibrant, joyous, and beautiful. Their story is just beginning, and I was fortunate to be able to capture it. So I was like, oh, that was such a beautiful, beautiful display of our story and also of our beautiful morning at the gardens. It was a beautiful morning, and it was a magical shoot. Like, everything was awesome. She was so sweet. She was so nice. And then me and Louis just had a really magical, great time. And I don't know if you want to add anything to that, Louis, before I go on to the other part.
Yeah, it was great. It was freezing out there. I know you talk about a little bit about that, but it was fun, though. You know, Chicago right now, the weather is just unpredictable. You just never know what's going on around there. But especially downtown, because you're right on the water. So, but it was worth every minute of it, though. It was a lot of fun. I love doing stuff like that. Like, I enjoy it, and I look forward to us doing that for the rest of our lives. We'll always do that kind of stuff. And we believe that the Lord will open many, many doors for us to have fun like that, because we both love it. But man, the photographer was amazing. Nicole, she did a great job. You know, she was personable. You know, it just wasn't somebody behind the camera lens, but she had personality with it. We connected with her. It was just a great time. The setting, you know, I've driven by that park so many times, that part of Grant Park, the Formal Gardens, but never really walked in there. So it's amazingly beautiful. Bridges, it's right next to the tracks, but you never know the tracks were down there till you get up close. But just the greenery, the scenery. Chicago's beautiful anyway, but that's probably one of the more beautiful parts of downtown over by the park. So it was just a great time. I had a lot of fun. I know you did too. So it was good.
And we got free cake. We got free cake right after we ran across the street to go to this cute little restaurant/cafe for brunch. And they saw us, I guess, across the street doing a photo shoot. So they asked us what it was for. We told them it was like our engagement photo session. And they gave us like free cake. It was really sweet. It was really nice. So it was just a really fun little sweet morning. But it was super early. So I kind of want to shift it over to what I really want to talk about. I kind of share it on Instagram, how we love the photo shoot. It was amazing. It looked so magical, so enchanting, like a fairy tale. And I want to talk about some of the obstacles that we overcome, that we had to overcome to make it look like that. And I feel like in life in general, we look at pictures, we look at people's relationships, we look at people's marriages or their lives, and things might look picture perfect. Things look like a fairy tale. And we wonder, oh, why isn't it happening for me? When is it my turn? Why is their life, you know, so amazing? And I kind of just want to talk about that. The pictures were great. Nicole was amazing. And the moment was enchanting. But to get to that so-called fairy tale moment, or the enchanted garden moment where it looks so perfect, we had to go through a lot of obstacles. Honestly, he's talking about it was cold. Y'all, it was beyond cold. It was freezing. We had to get up at 4. Was it 4 in the morning? Mm-hmm. We got up at 4 in the morning, and it was freezing. No one could do my makeup that early. I'm not a makeup artist, so that was disappointing because I really wanted my makeup done for that, so I had to do it myself. Freezing cold. I'm cold in regular weather. But y'all, this was cold, cold. Lewis was cold, and he had on a velvet jacket. So you know I was cold. I had that little dress. I was freezing. My nose was running, y'all. My allergies were going crazy in that garden. I kept sneezing. My dress was too long, so I kept tripping over it. It was muddy. My dress got really dirty. My shoes kept sinking in the mud. What else happened? Oh, we couldn't find a store that was open to find makeup because it was so early in the morning. And I didn't bring my makeup because I thought I was getting it done. So I was like, oh my gosh, I don't have makeup. So Lewis was just like really working at overtime to try to find me somewhere to go that was early in the morning. He was such a great support. I was a little bummed about that because I was really trying to get my makeup done. And so he was trying to be super supportive, but I was having like a mini meltdown. And then he was trying to help me. And then so much happened. Like it was just crazy. The wind kept blowing while she was taking pictures. My dress kept going crazy and falling down. My hair kept going all around. Like, it was a lot. And then we had to overcome some obstacles with me getting myself together, not letting the fact that I didn't get my makeup done, like, ruin the magical moment. And so I kind of wanted to use all that to say, like, in life, we can't compare y'all to nobody. You can't, don't compare your relationships, your season in life, how your life looks versus their life, because everything looks picture perfect. But in reality, there's always obstacles that a person is overcoming or had to overcome to get to that so-called picture-perfect moment in their lives. Nothing's perfect. Nothing is, we say fairy tale, but to get to that fairy tale in a relationship, in a marriage, in any courtship, it's going to be hard work. Like, I had to work hard. He had to work hard in that morning to not let those obstacles ruin that magical moment because it easily could have. I easily could have kept my little mini meltdown, could have easily just went off into something worse. And he was so sweet in trying to help me through it. And I had to get over it because I'm a person that I also don't want obstacles to ruin a moment. But again, I just want to encourage whoever is like in that state where you feel like everybody else's life looks better than yours, don't believe the hype. Everybody is going through something. You see the aftermath, the beautiful pictures. You see what you see on social media, but there's always a story behind that. And even if things are magical, like our photo shoot ended up being magical, there are obstacles we had to overcome, like me getting my attitude straight. You know, we had to overcome things to get to that moment. So just stay encouraged. If you're single on here, don't give up. Fairy tales do happen, but behind the fairy tale, there's always a process. There's always struggle. There's always obstacles. There's always negativity. So you have to overcome that and work really hard in any relationship to maintain a healthy relationship and to maintain those so-called fairy tale moments. But overall, like the photo shoot, it was so much fun because even with all that drama, we laughed, we had fun, we helped each other through. And Nicole was amazing, so she helped us. We were just laughing. Like, a lot of the pictures, if you guys clicked on the actual blog post, you see all, like, a lot more of our pictures. You see us laughing. Like, those were real moments. Because she kept asking us to look at each other and look at each other's eyes and stuff like that. And we just couldn't keep it together. We just kept busting out laughing. It was so funny, but it was a good time. So, go ahead, babe.
Yeah, that was good. We did have to overcome a lot that morning. And then I'll tell you this is one thing that, you know, anytime you have to go through something, like, you have a choice on how you go through it. You know, it's not always easy. The truth is, you're going to live through it and you're going to come out on the other side. But the thing is, are you learning from it? So you can go through it moping, whining, kicking, scratching, all of that. Or you can say, you know what, I'm going to use this to make me stronger, whether it's you go through it with a championship mentality, or you use it, like, if you're going to get ticked off about it, allow that to strengthen you and use that to push forward in a way to where you're not going to let certain situations happen to you anymore, or you're going to do the best you can. But, you know, my thing is, hey, if you're going through something, go through it like a champion. You got to go through it anyway. So, yeah. You know, go through it like a champion. Do the best you can. Stay encouraged and use what you're going through to better yourself and to strengthen yourself. You know, you hear a lot of stories about, you know, there was a time 3 years ago before I started coaching that I was just reading a lot of books and different things and watching a lot of videos on YouTube about millionaires and billionaires. And they had to go through something, but there was somewhere in there where what they was going through, there was like something that went off and said, you know what, I'm not going to remain in the place that I am no more. Or I'm not going to allow what I'm dealing with to master me. And they change something. And a lot of times out of those kind of situations, you will give birth to something amazing, which might make you wealthy, you know? So anytime you're going through something, a storm, any kind of thing in life, there's another side to that. But how you reach that other side depends on you. You can reach it in 2 days. You can reach it in 2 years. I think it all depends on your attitude and how you go through it.
Yeah. Well, that's it for my end. Like, I really enjoyed the photo shoot. It was lots of fun. It was a magical moment. It really was. And I'm just grateful for the favor of God. I'm grateful that we had that opportunity to do that. Because I really did want engagement photos, and so that was really awesome to be able to work with her and to be able to be involved with her blog as well. So that was pretty sweet. So, and the free cake.
Yeah, man. Oh yeah, we did get the free cake. We went to this little restaurant. I cannot remember the name right now, but are you still gonna cake? You can have that. You can have that. But yeah.
I know, I still have it.
But yeah, it was a great restaurant, nice little restaurant. Eat it. Oh, you're on a delay now, so. Yeah. Well, man, we hope everybody's doing well. It's pretty much all we had tonight, babe. You have anything else? Like champ. Yeah. Well, hey. All right, guys. Well, hope you guys are doing well. Thanks for hopping on with us. And we will talk to you guys soon.